去居酒屋。今天聊什么
？Hello， 欢迎各位来到直去居酒屋，我是主持人杰克飞。那今天很开心呢，特别邀请到我的好朋友 Grace， 然后跟她的男朋友 Victor， 那他们也是目前就是知名的 YouTuber， 那我们掌声欢迎。
Yeah,
hello，
你好，
你好，我是 Victor 跟 Grace。
Hello， 那想说能不能请两位先大概简单的做个自我介绍？
嗯，好，我是 Grace， 然后我就台湾人，然后男朋友你是哪里人？
我是加拿大人。
对，那我们一开始是远距离，他在加拿大，我在台湾，然后后来因为一个案子的关系，我们就是决定要结束远距离，为了那个案子先去跑其他的国家。那跑完那个其他国家以后，我们就先回到台湾。那原本是预计我们的计划会是半年在台湾，半年在加拿大，但由于是疫情的关系，所以我们目前都是以在台湾为主。
嗯 ，OK， 嗯，然后因为两位是 YouTuber 嘛，那因为我跟 Grace 其实很巧，是我们在几年前是 ITI 这个 program 的同学，
对，
然后我就发现哇 ，Grace 从毕业之后，那时候当时你还大四嘛，
对，
对，然后现在已经是一个就是往自己天赋热情的方向前进的 Young Talent。那因为我们这个频道也希望可以为大家访问，就是从生活中开始探索自我，然后从中找到自己真的有热情事物并且往前进活得很漂亮的朋友的故事。那我想说先想跟 Grace 问看看说，那你自己从大学毕业之后肯进职场，那一路到成为 YouTuber 这样的心路历程，大概中间做了哪样的自我碰撞跟实验？
嗯，大学毕业后我其实去了英国一年多，然后回来的第一份工作就是猎头，就是 Headhunter，对，然后待了也大概近两年的时间。那也就是因为因缘际会，然后跟各行各业的 candidate 聊过很多，那同时间也是跟他一起有去其他国家旅游。那中间就想说，哎，黑 hunter 之后我会想要做什么，然后我们两个都觉得希望能从事的工作是不受地点所限制。
嗯嗯嗯，
所以碰巧是因为我有一个 candidate 之前找我们去做一个案子，然后我们就决定用那个案子做起点，然后之后一直发展，不管是 YouTuber 也好， production company 也好，我们就一路这样继续下去了。
嗯，关于那个 production company 是指说你们会接一些可能是拍影片的案子，是这个意思吗？
对，像 YouTube 就是以我们自己当角色去，角色是介绍产品或者介绍地点也好。
是。
那如果是 Production House 的话，就是我们是专门当制片的，就是拍摄跟制片。所以假设随便一家公司想要找我们拍他们自己的形象广告，嗯，那我们就是以幕后的方式去帮他们制作影片。
OK， cool， cool，嗯，cool。那可不可以邀请也 Fit 也大概简单跟大家介绍您的背景，然后我，哦，这可以用英文没关系，就可以跟大家，那我们可以多了解一下 Fit 的一些相关的经验。 OK，
那 before we start our own company, what was your job and what did you do?
Oh, OK, before I was in an internal marketing team and I dealt with a lot of photo shoots and video shoots within that company, so I already had a background on like shooting videos and stuff, plus I've been doing video since I was in high school, so it's definitely,
wow,
like a passion of mineLike, I wasn't that good when I started, as everyone does, but it just was a hobby before,
mm-hmm.
But at some point, I knew I could take it to the next level, working on my own stuff. So what I did was work full-time in the marketing department, doing my full-time job, and then after that, it's either I do my client stuff, where I shoot videos for small businesses,or different companies, and that's where it all started. Just kind of like, it was my part-time job after that, and then I also had a YouTube channel, but it was very small, that I just kind of teach people how to use a camera.
Mm.
Yeah, so, and then after that, I wanted to travel,
yeah,
and then that's when we met, and then at the end of the...not at the end of the road, but at some point in our relationship, we said, how are we going to deal with the long-distance relationship? So yes. What about, since we both have the skills to manage a production company, let's start it, and also at the same time while we're building up clients, we do YouTube so that it's our part-time job.
Okay.
And our full-time job technically is our business. Yeah.
Oh, cool. Okay. Okay. 那其实因为我自己为了这次访谈，我看了很多两位的影片。Yeah, 真的真的。然后因为有一个 This FAQ, 然后也有很多人在台湾各地旅行。然后因为其实我后来有去问了一下我身旁的朋友，特别是可能他是外国在台湾工作，都看过你们的影片。他说 I know this lovely couple. 说 wow, so yeah, so your TA, I think. 然后我其实也很好奇是关于这个 channel 的发展，就是说一开始你们好像就比较 focus 在就是 LD 啊，就是 long distance 这样子的一个 topic。那后来转型到就是介绍台湾的各个面向，能不能请你们分享一下这个大概这个历程？
LDR 是因为一开始我们其实创这个 YouTube channel 没有想那么多，我们只是想说远距离实在太痛苦了，所以就把我们之前每一次见面都会拍成一个影片，等到我们就是在 apart 的时候有东西可以看，就是有种你知道去回忆的那种 memory。然后还发现成长了很快，就发现哦，原来这个是一个 community， 因为很多人其实都是suffering LDR， 就是大家就会说哦，看到你的影片就觉得很 inspiring， 就是会让我想期待下一次跟我的男朋友见面什么的。然后后来因为我们毕竟还是就相处在一起了嘛，所以我们就慢慢的变成是以台湾为主，想要让更多的外国人去认识台湾。
嗯，
对他来说，其实台湾一直都是他想要来的国家。那等到他真的来了以后，发现哦，怎么跟他想象中的还要再更好？那我们就觉得说，哎，那何不就是以你的经验，让更多以后等到那个 pandemic 结束之后，大家都可以来。那后来也发现很多是在台湾的人，然后是跟外国人交往，所以他们也会把这个影片分享给他们在其他国家的男朋友，
哦，是的，是的，
就说，哎，你看台湾多好，以后记得来台湾，对吗？
对，我看了很多你们影片的那个 comment 说，哇，it's really positive， you know， oh so beautiful and such a special sense Victor， you promote Taiwan to the world， so can I just listen to your opinion about this topic?
The videos that we made?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think Taiwan is a really beautiful place, especially I don't know, I feel like it's one of the countries that hasn't been really shown in worldwide kind of tour.
Mm-hmm.
So when we found the opportunity to like, oh, why don't we shoot our style and see how Taiwan is actually, instead of like reading blogs and stuff, like people can see more of the beauty of it. I think Taiwan is really nice and convenient, beautiful like destination spots and a lot of stuff to shoot here. It's nice.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
那我好奇就是两位看到彼此的第一印象，你们是就是立刻就觉得 that's it， 还是说你们怎么样？对，就是这段过程。
Like your first impression, your first
man. Yeah.
Oh, to you?
Yeah.
It was the same, I guess, like, I don't know, it's just, it felt natural. Like, everything was, like, we clicked right away, and there wasn't any, like, awkwardness, per se. Maybe, like, in the first 5-10 seconds.
Yeah, I don't have that. you
have that?
No,
I'm just,
like
the first,
know each other.
Yeah, but, like, it's the initial, it's like, oh, okay, we're, like, we feel like,we know each other for a long time already. Like,
oh,
there wasn't
yeah,
no,
yeah.
like, you know when you meet someone and then there's like, you're trying to feel out kind of like, oh, what kind of person they are. But with us, it was like that.
Yeah, but definitely is, oh, yeah,
yeah.
Grace is what I really like to, you know, together, right?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
But you know what, because we are classmates a few years ago, and she's really energetic, and always with a big smile, and everyone loves to talk to her. Yeah, it's my observation, yeah.
Mm.
Cool, really, yeah,
true,
it's yeah.
Yeah.
Sincerely. okay. 那因为其实我这次在准备这个访谈过程中，我有去 问了一下身旁，特别是他有就是 LDR 这样经验的朋友，他们都蛮想要知道说，就是你们在就是这段关系的经营上有没有什么 tips 可以跟大家分享的部分。
我觉得 like sharing the tips of being in LDR
yeah、
我觉得有两点是从我经验来看还蛮重要的。第一个是不管是开心或不开心，只要有事都不要憋在心里。就是一般的 couple 我觉得这个就已经是必须做到的，那尤其如果你有 distance 的话，就是还是尽量把所有你想讲的话都要告诉对方，不然你就是会一直有更多的揣测跟想太多、overreact 都会。然后第二个是如果最好是会有一个计划，是你们多久之后要一起做什么事情，就我们会 set target 还有 set 我们的 schedule、就什么时候再有下一次见面，那到什么时候可能是见家长啦或者是什么之类的、因为如果没有这个 plan 的话，其中一方多少都会觉得说那所以这个到底是有没有 commitment 的一段 relationship、所以这对我来说是 two point I would really say is more than、你有 any tip吗？
I think you said it. What you said the time. What about the communication?
The first, yeah, like don't hide anything in your heart. Just say it when you feel something wrong. That's.
I think those are two big ones. I don't have any.
Oh, another one I spent.、另外一个是我们之前因为我工作，
sure.
就我们的有时差，然后我工作其实也是一天十个小时、二个小时那种。就是
当时是加拿大在跟台湾这两个国家的
对
关哦，那差了
12-13个小时，
哇，就日夜是倒过来的，
对
对, 對, 對, 對，
所以有时候早上都没有认真上班，
哈哈，
对，所以我们就是因为一到五真的都很满，然后六我有时候会跟朋友出去，所以变成我们一定会固定 fix 在礼拜天的时候，一定要有一个比较
quality time， yeah， yeah， true。
我觉得这个是你在身为 LDR 的 partner， 你必须要 put effort on 的地方。
Yeah.
那因为刚好两位是 LDR， 又加上是不同国籍的一个结合，那我想问说有没有在 culture 上面有没有一些挑战，或者是觉得很意外的一些感受跟体验？
你好 ，culture shock 有吗？我们的
，your family or Taiwan？
我就是你、I'm your first、Asian girlfriend，、对吗
？Yeah，
有没有 different？
Yeah，
yeah。So culture differences， I would say just minor stuff like showering at night。
personality wise
it's
dating
wise, like I like it better because I feel like out of the past relationships I had, you were more into the relationship rather than like carefree, like we'll meet whenever, like we're dating, something like that, you know, like it's more towards like building something building a relationship better rather than like, oh, we're dating. Let's just see what happens, or, you know, see if it takes us somewhere.
Yeah.
But it's something building to the end. I guess the ending would be the marriage and, you know, growing old together. But it's something that I really like, and it's not like a culture shock. It was something that I actually was looking for.
Cool.
Yeah, so it was perfect.
Yeah, okay. 那国生这边的观点的就是对，
你说跟他在一起，我好像比较没有什么觉得 cultural difference， 因为他就可能我爸妈一开始对外国人的想法会是这个人会不会是玩玩而已，就是你知道他们有一点
可能比较对传统的，
对，然后或者是距离这东西真的很可靠嘛，你们之后要去哪，他们就有很多的想法。可是我一开始跟他交往的时候完全不担心这个的原因是他让人有一种安全感，就明明有这个 distance， 明明他是外国人，可他就是不会让我有一种我要哭了吗不会让我有一种好像我们是语言隔阂啦、或者是文化有差异，他就是不会，他就是有一种很有包容性，就假设我有的时候有些字我完全不知道就是 blank， 我不知道说什么，我说等一下我查一下，那有些外国人可能会有点不耐烦，可他就说没关系啊，你就是想好你想跟我讲什么你再跟我讲，就那种我都，所以我不会特别觉得 as you like a foreigner make me feel stress or uncomfortable. You're perfect.
Good. Yeah. That's good to hear.
Yeah. One more question. 因为其实两位比较像是 现在也算是 business partner、嗯、right、嗯、就是 co-founder right、嗯、但是就是你们毕竟也是 couple 然后又是工作上的 partner， 那这样子多重角色下就是会不会遇到一些挑战、嗯、或者是觉得有没有一些经验可以跟我们分享。
嗯，就是 we are a couple but as another business partner、
嗯、
so is there any conflict between us?
Yeah、
I think at first we had toiron out some issues、
mm-hmm.
As to any businesses out there, even if you're not like very close with your business partners, like just a joint venture or something like that. But in our case, we know how each other works and how to resolve issues because of long distance. So from there on, we kind of applied our skills of problem solving between issues,、between each of us. And then we apply that to thebusiness side of things. So if we're talking about something we don't agree on a topic, it's similar to how you deal with relationship stuff, but now you're talking about business. So there's、okay. not much issues.、just every business will have some struggle in the beginning to iron out a good system or a flow when you work.
Mm-hmm, yeah. Mm-hmm, okay.
Yeah.
How?
I don't know.
那鬼子这边有要补充的吗？就是针对这一点，
我就会变成假设是在工作上，如果是比较专业面的东西，然后就算遇到一些争吵，我都会以他的 idea 为主。Like if it's more professional stuff, I'll listen to you more.、
嗯、
那如果是 YouTube 或是其他东西，是我自己也觉得，哎、欸，这个东西有争议的空间，那可能就是会比较。equal 嘛，去讨论说到底要怎么解决比较好。那除此之外，我觉得不会说公事跟私事上面会让我们觉得有点 too overlap， 有点不舒服什么的都好。
哦、oh, ，cool。那我觉得你们可能就是 manage 的很好了，就不同的 mode， 你们可以就是 couple mode and working mode， 可以做一些比较好的 switch， right？ Okay， cool， cool， cool。
Yeah， there's always a limit when it's like the LDR time， like you spend quality time。On a certain time, let's say Monday, we always be there chatting. That's couple time.
Yeah.
And then now, since we're together, it's like this time, business time, and then this time, it's couple time.
It's a tips for, yeah.
Yeah.
yeah. Because my wife and I, we are similar with your status. Yeah, we are also business partner. So we have, okay, so this is wife, husband mode or partner mode. Okay, okay. It's
okay.
A change, right?
But sometimes it overlaps.
OK， 就是一个个人观点。我个人觉得，就是未来我们的工作就是 work life balance 是假议题，我觉得是 work life integration。
对，
就是我们可以 combine 我们的 passion 跟我们 的生活，把它做一个很优雅的整合，也是我很期盼的生活模式。对，那我最后想要问一下，因为就是那个 Steve Jobs。He says, all the dots will be connected,、
mm-hmm.
right? So, 所以从像 Grace 从 Hunter 到现在的 YouTuber,、
mm-hmm.
然后 Confit 从过去在可能从学生时代就开始很醉心于想要拍摄影片，那这整个过程中有没有一些你们的发现，或者是说针对这些在找寻天赋热情的朋友，可不可以给他一些你的 tips?
我觉得要相信一件事情，是你现在做的事情不一定是白工。就我一开始也想说，就我其实大学就是学这一类的，就是 communication art， 然后也是有学摄影什么。那我毕业想说啊，应该用不到了。然后后来做 hunter， 想说，哎，那之后跟 hunter 这个工作跟我未来有相关吗？我还不确定。但到现在我回头看，就觉得，哎，全部的东西都是有相关性的、啊，就是因为。那就是我的大学的 major， 所以跟他的就是兴趣相符，所以我们可以一起做这个 production house。那也是因为 Hunter 的关系，我可以去 manage 很多的 client。所以每一件事跟每一个过程，在你做决定的时候，你可能会想太多。那我的想法是你不要想太多，只要你当下是有兴趣的，你就是做了就对了。然后你不要觉得做就只是看看或者是摸摸看了解一下而已，没有，你要 go deep， 因为每一件事情都可以学习到一个新的技能。然后最后东西串起来会发生，你可能做梦也没有想过会发生的事。
Yeah, okay.
你要 try 吗？怎么 try？ 这个是 we're talking about every dot can be linked.
Yeah.
So that's I'm saying it like my undergrad, 然后 headhunter job, it linked to like production house. But what would you say to people who is still trying to find their passion?
Any advice or any suggestions?
Trying to find their passion. I would say if you don't know what it is, try to experiment on different stuff. Like maybe at one point you want to take photos, try taking photos, and if you really like it, try to pursue it. And then just keep trying, because if you don't try, you'll never know kind of what your passion is, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, yes, right now you need to work and you need to earn money to make a living.
Yeah.
But on the side, it's either you go on the path where you ask your boss or your whoever is managing you, say, oh, I really want to get into this role and see if there's anything that can go there.
Mm-hmm.
Or if that's not possible, then that's when you try at home, like see what you really like and kind of see where a path will, you kind of want to create a path for yourself in order for you to find your passion. And at the same time, probably in the long run, you want to mix both work and passion together.
Okay, thanks. Okay. 那我觉得很棒是，其实 Grace 给我们提醒是说，他自己从大学的主修到 Hunter 的工作，其实都累积了一些技能。那这个技能呢，把它 combine 在一起，却成为他现在成立就是制片或者是影片拍摄公司的一个很重要的底蕴。那 Peter 提醒我们是说，因为他鼓励我们就是 you know, 就 just do it， 就从实践中你会真的感受到自己 DNA 给我们的回馈，你就会知道说原来就是哎，这东西我到底喜不喜欢，或者是从都会引发更多的机会的串接。OK， 好，那今天非常谢谢就两位的时间。OK， 那我们职趣居酒会为各位带来更多关于那些找寻天赋热情的故事。那我们下次见喽，拜拜，
拜拜。